YouTube. I am the Sony M200MC Microcassette Tape Recorder. I don't look like most microcassette tape recorders because I am a product of Sony's ingenuity in design and construction. You might say I even look alien. Ooh, that gives me an idea. Hang on, you're gonna really enjoy this. Keep watching.
Tape recorders, cassette tape recorders especially, came out in many different sizes. And once Philips standardized the compact cassette, which we can see here, the machines were pretty much standardized following that. Here's an example. Here's a 1960s tape recorder made by Lloyd's that uses a standard compact cassette, which snaps right in like that. It was a great convenience when it came out. Now, later on, Olympus came out with a new format called the microcassette, which you can see right here. Now, the microcassette really is micro, because when you compare it to a regular cassette, look at the size difference. You see how small that is by comparison? It's about a quarter the size of a regular cassette. And that's very good for the convenience of portability. And machines like this Sony could be slipped in your pocket and carried around. Now, obviously you could not do that with something this size unless you had really big pockets. And an interesting thing about the way this is set up is a cassette, standard cassette, always feeds with the full reel on the left and the take-up reel on the right. The capstan is always on this side and the heads always go in the center. So you would see a machine, you'd snap the machine together like that, and then when you press play, and there's nothing on this tape so you won't hear any sound, it's just a blank tape, but you can see the motion is definitely going left to right. That gets a little confusing when you get into dual capstan and automatic reverse tape recorders. The Olympus design for the microcassette works in the opposite direction. The empty side is on the left and the full side is on the right. Now in this Sony machine it gets put upside down so it looks the same, and it does feed from left to right, but it's because it's upside down. So if I take this machine and open the door, put the cassette in, and then play it, it does look like it's the same as a cassette, but in actual fact this is what is happening. And you can see it is running backwards. You can see the little pinch roller, you just make that out, the little pinch roller is right here, and there's the capstan, and here is where the head is. Now on a regular cassette recorder the pinch roller and capstan are here and the head is over here. Now, what makes this machine very special is right here. and that is it has a directional indicator for forward and reverse. Yes, this tiny little machine is an automatic reversing microcassette tape recorder. Now, it's very hard to tell, but I'm trying to get the window just right so you can see it. There's two heads in the machine. There's one here, that's the forward head, and there's one here, that's the reverse head. So when it goes into reverse, and I can't show it to you with the door open, and you wouldn't be able to see it with the door closed, but when it goes into reverse, the forward head does not come into play, but the backwards head swings in and comes into play. All right, let's say you want to make a recording and you want to take full advantage of the auto reverse mechanism. So what would happen is you would put it in, oriented just like this, full reel on this side, empty reel on that side, and you'd start making your recording or your playback with this button in the forward mode. When it gets to the end, it will automatically change directions. So to see how that would happen, I'll take the cassette out, turn it over, put it back into the door, and close it. And now we see the full reel is here, and the empty side is here, and we're still in the forward motion. So let me push the button down, and just keep waiting for it. Did you see it turn? Do that again. Do you see the automatic change? Isn't that amazing? So, this works in both record and playback. So if you want to make a full recording on both sides of the tape without having to take the tape out and flip it over, you put it in forward, press record, and just keep recording. And when it gets to the end, it will automatically change directions and go all the way back. Once it reaches the end, though, it will stop because it only goes from forward to reverse, but not back to forward. I have the manual for it, the user's manual, and the user's manual has a date on it, 2001. And I saw somewhere on the internet something about it was produced till about the year 2003, and then I think they stopped producing these machines. But they are available. You can get them at Amazon.com, and you can get them on eBay. You'll find them from time to time, and you will find the prices vary considerably. All six sides of this machine have something for you to work with. Now we're looking at what I call the front, and here we see the speaker, and there is a microphone position switch and sensitivity switch, and it has three levels. It has lecture, meeting, and dictation, and there's a little indicator here and a lever here. Now when you put it into lecture, it does something very special. Watch this. Yes, the microphone pops out. And according to the Sony manual, it also becomes super directional, which means that it will not pick up from the top or the sides as much as it picks up from the front. Now, when you put it into the dictation mode, you can push the microphone back in or you can keep it out. And that is unidirectional, which means it's going to pick up directly from here, but not from the sides. And if you put it into the meeting mode, it will pick up omnidirectional, which means that all of these vents will work. The front also shows us a three-digit tape counter right here, a little tiny one. And there is a cue button. And we also have three indicators. One is for the microphone, so it tells you that you're recording. The other is a battery indicator that tells you you have power. And the other is a battery is low indicator. And then here we see the directional indicator. And that directional indicator is managed by this switch up here. So you can see how the green arrow changes. So in this particular machine, there really is no forward or reverse because it can go in either direction. Now let's take a look at the top. Up at the top here, we see the master controls. This is the record button. This is the play either direction button, and this is the stop and eject button. Here's the switch that we looked at before for the reversing, and this is the fast forward or the rewind. And of course, here's the microphone. Now we keep going around and we're upside down, so I'll turn it over. And we see we have some features here. This is a pause control. Now it is a switch rather than a mechanical pause control. So when you push it down, it just simply cuts off power to the motor. And then there's some two very interesting little bits here. One is called Fast PB, which means fast playback. And then this one is the VOR circuit. And when you push it on, it means that it's voice-activated recording. So if the machine is sitting in a meeting and nobody's saying anything, it'll shut itself off until somebody says something. And you can turn that on and off. And then here we see how to put in the batteries so we get the polarity correct, plus a nice label telling us all about the machine. Now we look at the bottom and we see some more ingenuity. First of all, we see here is a compartment lid, and there's where the two little batteries go in. It takes two AAA size batteries, and there's no marking on the door about the polarity, which is why you have to look at the side. And that takes care of that. And then here is a very clever idea. You notice how thin this machine is. You know, here is the cassette. It's not even as wide as a cassette. So to give it stability, it has these two little feet. Now watch what happens when I slide this. These two little feet come out, and so they help keep the machine from falling over. Now I've got it on a towel, so it's more likely to fall over. And if I were to pull it back, it's even more likely to fall over. So they're not all that effective, but they're very cute the way the whole thing works. It's almost like landing gear on an aircraft. So that's kind of fun. In the back here, we have even more. We have the standard 2.4 centimeter and the 1.2 centimeter speeds, which are standard on these machines. And here is a little tiny power jack for an AC to DC adapter. And now going to the front, we see there's an earphone output, and here's the volume control. So this machine is totally loaded with features. Something that is characteristic, though, of these machines is that they have a very, very limited frequency response. These machines are made for dictation, and that's why there's so much attention paid to the microphone. The frequency response is about 400 to 4,000 cycles per second. The range is perfect for vocal, but it's obviously not very good for music. So if you were to take this, and you'd have to use a microphone because there's no auxiliary input, and try to record a stereo recording of a CD or a symphony orchestra or something like that, you're going to be very disappointed because it is not designed to do that. However, 400 to 4,000 cycles per second will work with some musical instruments. And when I was looking up about microcassettes on the internet, I found a very fascinating blog article by an independent musician who is one of the independent musicians who's also a conceptual artist. And he is putting out an album entirely on microcassette. How is he doing that? Well, part of it is, of course, he's speaking or singing into the machine. But how, I wondered, could he play a musical instrument that this could record and play back without any serious problems? And I found the solution. Old Faithful, the Yamaha PSS-80 electronic keyboard. Now, why am I using this keyboard? Because it has a very limited range from F through C, and it's only 2.5 octaves. That is very close to the range this microcassette recorder is designed to make a recording of. So let's have the tape recorder make a recording of this keyboard. Now I turn on the Yamaha and I will do the demo song. So here we go. Thank you. Okay, so we now have made our recording. All we have to do is put the microphone back. I've stopped the machine. Now, let's hear it play back fast as we review. And now we're going to hear it play back. You could see how if you were an independent musician or a conceptual artist or just somebody who is experimenting with sound, this machine could be quite useful. And you could come up with some very interesting sounds to play. Like, for example, suppose you're a band. Obviously, you're not going to record your band onto this machine because it's just going to distort. But you could record something like this keyboard. It could be, you know, a different brand. As long as it has the same range, that's all that matters. You can have different tones. It doesn't make any difference. Just it's the frequency response we're concerned with. And you could record it into this machine and use it as a solo track. You know, for example, you could have it as a counterpoint to a melody that you're playing. Or it could be a harmony to a melody that you're playing. The machine has a unique sound to it, and if that's the sound you're looking for to put in your song, well, here you go. You've got the machine to do it.
Thank you for watching the video about me, the Sony M200MC Microcassette Tape Recorder. I hope you enjoyed seeing about all that I had to offer people when I was being manufactured. Please stay tuned to ClydeSight Channel for more vintage tape recorder videos. And thanks for watching. Bye-bye, YouTube.